I'm going to speak today on a subject which I hope you will find interesting. A subject that revolves around something you read in the papers every day, see on YouTube, on television. I'm going to be talking about celebrities. Little question, what is a celebrity? Celebrity basically is somebody who's famous. Somebody is well recognized, right? But we add on a dimension to that, and that dimension is that somebody well known, somebody famous that I would like to be like, right? Somebody I hold in respect, somebody I hold in awe, somebody perhaps I love, somebody I admire, therefore would like to emulate. Emulate meaning I would like to be like that person. Right? So that is where celebrities derive the power that we use in advertising. That is, the celebrity is endorsing something, selling something. Therefore, I would like to do what the celebrity does. But for today's presentation, I said celebrities are famous. But if I bring together two celebrities, especially the ones who are married or in a relationship, will they become 1 plus 1 equal to 2, or would it be 1 plus 1 equal to 11? Multiplier. Right? Now, I have been researching celebrities for about 15 years now. So I have a huge database of how some of them have progressed, some have gone up, some have gone down. Some have become even more well known, some have faded out, and so on and so forth. But when I looked at, say, what is possibly the best known couple around today, which is Virat, his wife Anushka, and the happy couple they make, and the beautiful ad some of you might have seen of Manyavar Mohe and whatever, and it evoked all these warm, nice, cozy little feelings, and I said perhaps they have the power to do together what they are individually doing and more, right? So just to have a common understanding first of what is a power couple, so that I shouldn't be saying something and you should be, you know, wondering in your mind that you have a different definition. So first and foremost, a power couple is a couple who are famous and accomplished together. Now, important word. Together they are seen to be successful and influential. But more importantly, individually too, they are successful and influential. So simple enough definition. Do we all agree? Okay. So if that be the definition, where did this whole term of power couple actually come from? The first time the word power couple from the perspective of advertising or communication started to be used was not very far back. The FIFA World Cup of 2006, where you would know the English captain David Beckham and his wife Victoria, more popularly known as Posh Spice, were mentioned so frequently in the papers that the term power couple as a nomenclature became very, very famous and almost common currency in India. So that's the background from where this power couple story sort of starts. Now the question is, till this 2006 nomenclature came about, why didn't we have our own power couples? Now, my problem with some presentations like this is I take examples from a time when most of you were not born. But what to do? But I am sure there are some in this room who recognize this couple. You know who they are? Dilip Kumar, Saira Banu. Moot question, why were they not a power couple? You see, by the time they got married, Dilip Kumar was already into sunset mode as far as his acting career was concerned. And his wife, Saira Banu, to be honest, was never really an A-plus lister. And if you go back to my definition, which is I put it out, both of them individually should be alpha-alpha. Right? So that's one potential power couple we have to tick off the list. Let me look at another power couple. Anybody recognize this? Sunil Dutt, father of Sanjay Dutt, and Nargis, his mother. Now again, when they got married, actually, Nargis was the more well-known part of the couple. Sunil Dutt was not as well known. He went on to become a parliamentarian and a very famous guy in his own right in later years. But by that time, his wife, soon as they got married, decided to settle into domesticity. So that dimension of a power couple never really became a reality. You recognize them? From 1969 to 1971, Rajesh Khanna gave 15 blockbuster super hits, the maximum anybody has ever given as a solo lead. He was, without doubt, the heartthrob of India. And then he went on to marry Dimple Kapadia, who was the sensation of her generation, the leading lady of Bobby. But what happened? They got married. Unfortunately, from day one, that marriage remained kind of rocky. And you never really saw them in the same frame. So no power couple. Mr. and Mrs. Bachchan. Once again, like the Nargis example, few would know that Jai Bahaduri was actually the more famous part of the couple when the two married. So as Amitabh Bachchan kept going up in terms of his brand, Mrs. Bachchan decided to settle into domesticity. So that power couple as a couple didn't actually happen. What happened with this couple? Recognize them? The Right Honorable Nawab Mansoor Ali Khan Patodi, the youngest ever Indian captain, and his wife, the ebullient, beautiful, charming Sharmila Tagore. But same problem. By the time they got married, the Nawab was almost out of cricket. Sharmila stayed on in movies for a couple of years. But then, she also headed into domesticity. So the power couple didn't happen. Now, yet another famous couple, the evergreen Dharmendra, his dream girl wife, Hema Malini. Controversial marriage, but never again seen in the same frame. They wouldn't just be seen in public together. So you're not even seen in public together, you can't become a power couple. Right? Aha. You recognize them? Ranbir Kapoor's parents, the one and only Rishi Kapoor, the most famous of the Kapoors during his era, and his pretty wife, his sweetheart, Neetu Singh. Unfortunately, beautiful marriage, but went rocky in the first few years. They're a very nice, charming couple today, but the initial years were not very good. So the power couple dimension just didn't happen. I said, Bollywood se nahi mila, to cricket se mil sakte the. You recognize who they are? Well, you said Gavaskar, you didn't get the other name right. So that is Sunil Gavaskar, India's first double centurion, India's little man, the famous opener, and his wife, Marshneel. You actually answered the question. He was famous, he was well known, he was always in the thick of whatever was happening. The lady never kept pace. So that power couple didn't happen. Recognize him? Again, former Indian captain Mohammad Azharuddin and his very, very, very pretty, very stylish wife, Sangeeta Bijlani. Just about when the two of them were starting to make waves, Azharuddin got into the match-fixing controversy, got tainted, they broke up, the marriage ended. So no power couple there. You would have thought at least Sachin Tendulkar wouldn't let us down. He married a doctor, Dr. Anjali, a nice lady. But she kind of decided to stay in the shadow of the husband. So never independently became an alpha personality. So the Tendulkars, while well known, never took on the mantle of being a power couple. I'll take just one last example. Somebody again I thought could have made the grade. Mahendra Singh Dhoni, who married this nice little girl next door called Sakshi. And you would have said, here we have now the making of a power couple. But again, Sakshi Dhoni decided one famous person in the family was enough. She kept in his shadows, so no power couple. Right? So we've done a good enough elimination. So I zoomed into now 2019, last quarter, and I said, let's list out the 10 most famous power couples in this country. So who did I finally get through a first round of research? I got Akshay and his wife Twinkle. I got Abhishek Bachchan and his beautiful wife Aishwarya. I got Ranbir and Alia, though they are still not married. Priyanka and Nick Jonas. Mr. and Mrs. Devgan, Saifina, Deepveer, the Nenes, Shah Rukh Khan and Gauri, and last but not the least, Virushka. Now, time is short, so I wouldn't go into how we did the research, but when we listed them out and researched them, 4 out of these 10 didn't make the grade. They didn't hit my desired threshold, so I knocked them out. So that's the brand attribute wheel across 24 attributes, going from trustworthy, respected, and dynamic to successful, arrogant, and reliable to up-to-date, traditional, and straightforward. So 24 attributes, 6 set of couples. We won't go into each of them. But that's what the Virushka wheel kind of looks like. The Ranalia wheel looks a little different. Saifina, you can see how that kind of pans out. Near tops of the circle. And Abhi Ash. So that's what they look like. You know, the attributes are too tiny for, I'm sure, all of you to read from that distance. But that's what they, you know, kind of stock up to. And that's how the attributes go. The first one here is trustworthy. I got respected. And that's how they kind of stack up. For those of you who want to read the report, it's on the internet. So nothing that you can't access later after this presentation. How did it all kind of come together? Virushka lead on trustworthy and respected. Deepveer lead on fun and prestigious. Twinkle and Akshay, despite being the oldest amongst the 6, lead on charming and distinctive. And Ranbir, Alia, despite not being tied in matrimony, score very highly on high quality, different, up-to-date, and stylish. But I also want to tell you that Virushka are top on arrogance. So that tells you where do these brands or these couple brands kind of stack up. So if you are a clever brand manager, and soon all of you will be working in companies, and you are making the choice of a celebrity, especially choosing a power couple as a celebrity couple, you know the attributes that best match the ones listed here. So let's go back to where we started. Virat Kohli, his wife Anushka, together they come together as Virushka. Well, for now, Virat endorses 25 brands, currently 25 brands. His wife does between 8 to 9. Together, they endorse 4. But yes, I think if you ask me where are power couples headed, I think the direction really is up. You're going to see more and more of them. You will see more interesting ones which will surface. Some who are not on my list, some who are younger, some who will make for odd couples. And much would also depend, therefore, on what the creative guys can actually do with them. Where will power couples work best? Wherever you want to show togetherness. So, home products, luxury products, big cars, vacations. So many categories lend themselves naturally to bringing in a couple rather than bringing in a single celebrity. But, and that's the last bit that I'm going to say, the couples have to stay together. They have at least publicly be seen to be together and happy. They have to seem to be a couple that is emulatable. I started from there. So emulatable means I'd like to be like them. So power couples is a emerging category, interesting category. I am studying it from the pure standpoint of academics. I'm sure you're reading about it on page 3 and all the various sites you visit on your mobile. Interesting category, interesting people, and I thought this would be an interesting topic for a TED Talk. Thank you.